Key findings from the 2017 Ghana Maternal Health Survey. The 2017 Ghana Maternal Health Survey, or GMHS, is designed to provide data for monitoring the maternal health situation in Ghana. The 2017 GMHS is the second maternal health survey to be carried out in Ghana, along with six demographic and health surveys implemented between 1988 and 2014. 26,324 households and 25,062 women aged 15 to 49 were successfully interviewed in the 2017 GMHS. This represents a response rate of 99% for both households and women. The 2017 GMHS provides estimates at the national level for urban and rural areas, for three zonal levels, and for each of the 10 administrative regions in Ghana. The survey results show that Ghana has made progress in maternal health indicators over time. Fertility in Ghana has decreased over the past three decades, from 6.4 children per woman in 1988 to 3.9 children per woman in 2017. This means that women in Ghana currently have, on average, about four children. More women are now using family planning. One in four married women in Ghana is using a modern method of family planning. This is a five-fold increase from 5% in 1988. The most popular modern methods of family planning are injectables, implants, and the pill. 6% of married women use a traditional method of family planning. The 2017 GMHS also measured childhood mortality. More children in Ghana are surviving early childhood than ever before. Under-5 mortality is the probability of a child dying before their fifth birthday. In Ghana, under-5 mortality has dramatically decreased from 155 deaths per 1,000 live births in 1988 to 52 deaths per 1,000 live births in 2017. This means that one in every 19 children dies before their fifth birthday. Antenatal care coverage in Ghana is improving. Since the 2007 GMHS, more women are receiving antenatal care, or ANC, from a skilled provider such as a doctor, nurse midwife, or community health officer nurse. Since 2007, more women are attending four or more ANC visits and beginning ANC within their first trimester. Delivering in a health facility decreases risk for both mothers and newborns. Nationwide, delivery in health facilities has increased over the past 10 years, from 54% in 2007 to 79% in 2017. While this is very good news, still, 20% of births or stillbirths were delivered at home, putting mothers and babies at risk. The 2017 GMHS asked women about deaths of their sisters to determine maternal mortality. Maternal mortality includes deaths of women during pregnancy, delivery, and 42 days after delivery or end of pregnancy, excluding deaths that were due to accident or violence. The maternal mortality ratio, according to the 2017 GMHS, is 310 deaths per 100,000 live births for the 7-year period before the survey. The Ghana Ministry of Health Operation Plan aims to reduce the maternal mortality ratio to 203 deaths per 100,000 live births by 2030. Zonally, there are differences in the maternal mortality ratio point estimate, but the confidence intervals overlap, suggesting that the differences are not statistically significant. The 2017 GMHS used a verbal autopsy questionnaire to collect information on the deaths of women who died since January 2012 from caretakers of the deceased. Physicians then reviewed the questionnaires to arrive at a consensus on the underlying cause of death. The most common cause of death among women aged 12 to 49 in the 5 years before the survey was infectious and parasitic disease, 24%. Maternal deaths accounted for 14% of all deaths. 7% of deaths were caused by transport accidents and other external causes. 45% of deaths were due to other disease. The cause of 10% of deaths could not be determined. Maternal deaths are divided into three categories: Direct maternal deaths refer to deaths resulting from obstetric complications during pregnancy, labor, or 42 days after delivery or end of pregnancy. Two-thirds of deaths were direct maternal deaths. Indirect maternal deaths result from non-obstetric complications aggravated by pregnancy. More than one-quarter of maternal deaths were indirect maternal deaths. Finally, unspecified maternal deaths have an unknown underlying cause that took place during pregnancy, childbirth, or 42 days after delivery. 6% of maternal deaths were due to unspecified maternal causes. 71% of women who died in the 5 years before the survey sought medical care at either a public and/or private health facility. Outside the medical sector, 37% of women sought any combination of traditional, herbal, and/or spiritual medicine. As you can see, the 2017 Ghana Maternal Health Survey provides a wealth of information about the maternal health situation in Ghana. Results of the survey show where progress has been made, as well as areas for improvement. The 2017 GMHS provides data for program managers and policy makers to use to make evidence-based decisions to improve the maternal health situation in Ghana. The 2017 GMHS was implemented by the Ghana Statistical Service and the Ghana Health Service from 15 June through 12 October 2017. The funding for the 2017 GMHS was provided by the Government of Ghana, the United States Agency for International Development, the European Union Delegation to Ghana, and the United Nations Population Fund. ICF provided technical assistance through the DHS program, a USAID-funded project providing support and technical assistance in the implementation of population and health surveys in countries worldwide. For additional information on the results of the 2017 GMHS, please contact the Ghana Statistical Service in Ghana and the DHS program in the USA.